Good evening! Welcome to HeartGut! Sorry for the, there are no more seats up here, so I cannot put any more seats, but if you'd like squeeze against the side, maybe. And maybe a little bit later on in the evening, if people are drunk, you can sit in their laps. I want to begin, though. We're going to first hear a piece by Kasia and Hamna. Kasia is, like all of us, a protege of Ayn Rand. But unlike most of us, Kasia actually came from collectivist Russia using the same method that Ayn Rand did, which is she cut down a couple of trees and made a raft and rowed on the raft, or floated, I guess you float on a raft across the ocean and into the harbor and the phallic glory of Manhattan, where we are now. While she was floating, she wrote five thematically linked novels on the bark of the trees. And what you're going to hear tonight is an excerpt from one of those pieces. Ladies and gentlemen, Kasia.
Thank you very much, Michael. And also Ayn. The lunch ladies are pear-shaped and tyrannical. Heads down, they bellow, to hush us for the reading of the menu. If you bring lunch from home, they call that cold lunch. You can't eat it till your classmates have been served hot lunch. And they decide the order in which the tables are called. Tell you what, we'll make it up to you, they say. Since you were the last to get lunch, you can throw out your garbage first. Other kids seem unfazed by the injustice. They throw out their wonder crusts. I bring my crusts home. Our father eats them like an appetizer. My sandwich is always Polish rye. Other kids have fruit roll-up and gushers. I have raisins. I tell our father that the lunch ladies make us hold up two fingers in a V for quiet. He doesn't get it. Don't do that, he says. Two fingers mean victory. We're not free here. After dinner, he puts on his jacket. We ask where he's going. He says, into the world. Then he comes back. Every day at lunch, I walk over to Heather and tap her shoulder. Bathroom, she asks. I nod. She asks the pear lady and we go. Just say it, Heather says one day. Just say bathroom. But I don't speak. Every morning, the class sits in a circle to talk about the weather. And I want to say something, but nothing comes. Every afternoon, as I change from school clothes to home clothes, our mother asks, did you say anything today? No! Even Nadia talks, says Mrs. Mattia, Nadia's para. Nadia is in mainstream, which means mostly special ed, but some regular. Nadia's voice throws me into a panic. During nap time, kids try to trick me into speaking. One day, I decided it'd be weird if I suddenly showed my voice, so I resolved to wait out the year in silence. Then comes my mid-year report card, promotion in doubt.